Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. Last time we took on the 200cc Egg Cup using Baby Peach, and this time we are finally using Toadette. I've seen quite a few comments suggesting Toadette, and we're going to be using the combination suggested by... I'm sorry if I get the name wrong, this was on the 200cc Banana Cup, Lenone17? I hope I got the name right. And that was, of course, Toadette. They said any tiny cart, which doesn't really make much sense because the carts are scaled to the character. So I guess that just means we can use whatever cart we want. So I'm going to go ahead and choose something we haven't used yet. Did we use the GLA? I'm going to look that up right now. I'm going to look through the thumbnails really quick because I know we've used some Mercedes stuff, but I don't know if we use the GLA. Yeah, we use the GLA with dry bones. Never mind. All right, then. In that case, we'll use the Prancer. Why not? They suggested we use the Monster Wheels, which are right there, and the... Where is it? The Wario Wing. Wow, actually pretty even stats. I'll accept that. Actually, wait. Let me check that. My auto-acceleration was on, apparently. How long has that been on? Anyway, and we're taking on the 200cc Triforce Cup with Wii Wario's Goldmine, SNES Rainbow Road, Ice Ice Outpost, and Hyrule Circuit. Let's go. Okay, here we go. The Prancer. Now, if you give it, like, smaller wheels, it looks adorable, but you give it monster wheels, and it just looks like an adorable death machine, so... Yeah, I'm not gonna complain about that. This actually looks a lot better than I was expecting it to. And it's controlling pretty good as well, surprisingly. I feel like its traction will be a little bit lower. Even though, the stats were kind of even across the board, it's a monster truck now, so that kind of does make the traction suffer a tiny bit. At least in certain places, like in underwater sections, for example. But I think in Wario's Goldmine, we're going to be okay. Unless I screw up getting the boost right there. We've got a decent enough lead already to where we can probably try and get a secondary item that's not a coin. No, I'm going to wait. I don't want to risk it just yet. I'm going to wait until we've got a little bit more of a lead. Or until we lose this banana from a red shell or something like that, because one hit and they're gonna catch up to us. So, you know. And there it is. Lightning. And we ended up losing both items, so that's nice. Gonna regain some coins as well. 1, 2, 3. Let's grab these ones from this edge. 4, 5, 6. Oh, never mind, we're up to 10. Oh, turn around. There we go. I need to kinda angle that a little bit better, or just take the regular path. And now Daisy's starting to gain on us a little bit. I keep looking down at the map and not focusing on the road, and that's kind of what I need to do. I do that in real life. No, I'm kidding. I don't just stare at my GPS all the time, but... Anyway. Oh, we've actually managed to pull away on that corner just then, even though we did fall down to the outer edge of it. Don't fly off the screen! Okay. I'm just gonna focus for this last bit. There's a bullet bill coming. We're gonna probably screw this up again. Yep, hit the brakes! Oh god. There's a blue shell! Oh, okay. Boost away, Toadette! Oh, don't do it, Wario. Don't do it, Wario! Wario, no! Oh my god, we still got first. Okay. I don't know what Wario just did. But okay. I'll take it. I'll take it. God damn it. Okay. SNES Rainbow Road, 200cc, sharp corners, not a cart with stupid high handling. Let's see how we do here. And when I say sharp corners, I mean like every aspect of them is sharp. They're all jaggedy too. Alright, let's just focus here. I'm not even going to try for the shortcut because I'll fail it because we're going too fast. In fact, now that I'm saying that, can we get this boost, actually? We can get that jump! Okay, I'm gonna hit the brakes, though. I'm not about to boost off the edge. Now that I say that, though, we're actually doing okay. Baby Daisy also took the shortcut, but she was able to drift around the corner because she's a CPU, so of course she was. She doesn't get affected by bullcrap, apparently. Like that, for example. Well, at least you avoided that other red shell. Alright, let's get this corner going. Start to build up a tiny drift from that. Two red shells, I will gladly accept. Gonna protect ourselves from that one. Throw that one at Baby Daisy. Get that, let's... Oh! Did Baby Daisy fall? No, I don't think she did. Yeah, she's like... How did you not get affected by the lightning, actually? Okay. Oh, you know what? Because we hit her with the red shell, she was probably in the stun animation while the lightning struck. And she's right there. God damn. Get rid of that red shell. There we go. Oh, I needed more than a coin, ideally. I'm not going to get that mushroom because I'll probably screw it all up. And I'm going to go this way. Oh, that was a freaking mistake. God damn it. All right. Of course, I knew that would be the course that screwed us over. So I either play a lot better when I'm not commentating, or I'm just a lot more lucky when I'm not commentating, because as you saw, the Yoshi was still right behind me, even though I had a pretty much flawless race that time around. So, I don't know. And look at Toadette not getting affected by the laws of physics right there, just going around that corner even though she should have boosted off the side. Anyway, moving on. Oh boy, ice physics and 200cc. Now, we got a little lucky when it came to Mount Wario being like the only other ice course, in the fact that I guess just because that's my favorite course and I've played it so much, we didn't do all that bad. We didn't suck on that. But this one, I call it bad, bad outpost for a reason. It's first bad is because it's not a great course. Second bad is because I'm kind of bad at it sometimes. So. Yeah, we'll see how we do here. First lap hasn't been terrible so far, but at the same time, we were just kind of trying to pull ahead of everybody, but I feel like we're going to get blue shelled up the butt, and that's just, they're spiky, so that's not going to be pleasant, but, you know, alright. Second lap, didn't pull that off, going at 90 degrees to the side of the road, apparently hitting a banana. Good job, Toadette. And Yoshi is gaining on us once again. Was Yoshi the one who was, in second place on the first run through, or was that someone else? Because I know Wario was there, but I feel like Yoshi was. And now they're shooting fireballs down here at us. And we're in a narrow, like, corridor pathway thing, so fireballs are pretty much guaranteed to hit us, so I was kind of surprised that we avoided those then. Gonna hold on to this banana for right now. I was gonna try and drop it on them, but I don't want to risk losing my defense, because, I could easily drop that and then both of them fire a red shell and then I've only got defense for one of them, so. Let's not do that. And that's another thing, I feel like I take more risks when I'm not commentating because I'm focusing purely on the race and nothing more. But I think we're gonna be okay. I'm gonna drop one right there, drop another one, okay. Ice Outpost wasn't that bad. If you look at the map, it's really kind of a simple course, but the actual winding pathways can be a little confusing, but. Alright. Moving on to the last race. Okay, Hyrule Circuit. Kind of fitting that we're on the other horse-themed vehicle. Not the Hyrule Cycle, but you know, the Prancer, so let's see how we do here. Like I said, horses are kind of fitting for Hyrule, because Epona and stuff like that. Let's get some rupees, get our top speed up. I don't understand how Wario pulled ahead so much already, but that's fine for right now, because it's the first lap, I guess. Someone hit that middle one, maybe? No one hit the middle one, damn it. And that's a wall. Oh, well, we hit Yoshi, though, so that's okay. There goes Morton. I don't think we've used Morton yet. We should probably do that. Because we've only got two episodes left after this one, and there's still, I want to say, like, 8 characters that we can choose from. I just don't remember what they all are right now. That we haven't used yet, that is. Alright, Morton is just on Wario's tail right now. And he stole my items. Okay. Well, I'm going to wait and see what he has. Because if he red shells me, then I'd rather have protection. Yep, there it is. And we got hit by lightning anyway, so it doesn't matter because everybody lost their items now. Alright, mushroom I will gladly accept. Hit that one, hit the third one. Apparently it didn't activate in time, okay. Well, you got to see what the frickin' Master Sword looks like again, but we didn't actually get to use it. Boost across here. Alright, that was probably a bad idea, actually. I probably could have just made it across there because it's 200cc, but... Alright, back in first. No real lead to speak of right now. But we do have a green shell, which is more than we would have had beforehand. Two green shells. Wario is right on our tail. Alright, the music is amped up now, though. I love it. Alright, didn't get that one. Didn't get that one. And didn't even get that one. Okay, well, at least I didn't screw up the angle right there. You know what? I'm gonna do this. That was a bad idea. I should have jumped. Actually, we've got a decent lead now, so it's not that bad that I did that. Alright, get rid of the green shells, and we're done. Of course, SNES Rainbow Road is the only one that screwed us over. As expected, but there we go. Final race in the bag, another 60 points. Not bad, Toadette. And of course, it had to show the one race that you didn't see, or one of the two races that you didn't see, because we played back through and didn't show that. Okay, and, well, there's Link on the other horse-based vehicle, it's like they knew. With that, that's gonna go ahead and do it for this episode of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. If you guys enjoyed, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below, and of course, stay tuned for the next one, where we will be doing the 200cc Crossing Cup, and I'll see you guys then.